Some years ago, I was filming quite often in Huai Kha Khaeng Wildlife Sanctuary here in Thailand. And one day, one of the rangers suggested that I take a look along a stretch of the river near the headquarters. And as you can see, I was in for an absolutely delightful surprise. Not just a pair of otters, but one of them, as you can see here, is completely white. Fishing in this deeper water just behind a weir that has been created in the river. Extraordinary technique that these animals have. Egrets looking on, perhaps they're hoping to get a bit of leftover fish. Now, this animal is not an albino. This is something known as leucism. It's a leucistic otter. The difference being that in albino animals, they lack melanin in the whole of the body, including the eyes, which will therefore show up as pink, and such an animal would have impaired eyesight, whereas leucistic animals only partially lack pigment in the body. So in the case of this individual, the fur completely lacks that pigment and is showing as pure white, but the eyes are unaffected. What a beautiful sight this is. My goodness, I can't believe my luck on this day. My absolute favorite animals in all of the world, but I've only ever previously caught glimpses of them. The pair went up the river away, and I've run up through the forest and come to a position up ahead of them, but I'm afraid I may have given myself away. And even though I'm behind a bush here, I think this one is not entirely happy and a little bit suspicious. So it's headed back down to where I originally saw them. These are smooth-coated otters, or smooth otters, found throughout much of Asia. At one point, a jungle fowl came up on the side of the river, the ancestor to all the hapless domestic chickens that are so badly treated around the world. This one in the wild, where it should be. The egret still looking on, watching the professionals, as it were. This pair of otters definitely seem to be a little bit more wary than they were when they first came out. You can see a slipway here behind the root of that tree on the bank of the river. And I would imagine that the otters have a den up the bank there, either in amongst boulders or down under tree roots that they've dug out, or they've taken over an existing burrow that was created by another animal. A little bit of mutual grooming, perhaps to reassure one another, and indeed they do look quite relaxed now that they are close to the bank and to their home. They go on down the river, and this was a real problem for me because I knew I wasn't going to be able to follow. The forest is very thick at that point, but I did move on down a little bit. But luckily for me, just a few moments later, they came back again. Clearly, a lot more wary than they were at the beginning. back to the deeper pool of water for a bit more fishing. And I thought they were going to come back on down the river, but clearly they're very spooked by something now, and they shoot back over the wall and up the bank.